lights out here in Barcelona for Moto2 in 2022. It's a great start from pole position by number 13, Chelsea Vietti. Jake Dixon got away really good as well, the 96 bike from the second row. Likewise, his teammate Albert Reynas on the gas machine. But it looks like it will be Dixon around the outside of Chelsea Vietti in the first corner. Dixon leads.
Ben Schneider way out wide there on the outside of turn one, so he's lost ground. He's watching Iagora. He has made some good progress. He's gained at least three places on the first lap. Ben Schneider, though, way down the field. We'll see him struggling to try and regain the track. He's way outside. He's down to 24th.
Perfect launch there then from fourth place for Jake Dixon around the outside of Vietti on the brakes into the first corner. Dixon then, Roberts trying to go around the outside, and these two men of course were first and second at the start of that short seven lap restarted race in Portimão when Dixon went down the first lap. Roberts attacking him hard on the front end into turn five, and Joe Roberts then smoking Joe already at the front of this Barcelona Grand Prix. He leads through turn six.
Chelsea Vietti then in fourth position. He's got Albert Arenas for company in fifth. Then it's Agoura in sixth. Marcel Schrotter in seventh. Augusto Fernandez made an initial good launch but didn't quite get the best of a battle on the brakes into turn one, so Augusto Fernandez still down in the eighth position that he started from.
Been a good first lap so far for joint world champs leader Iagura. Started 10th, he's got himself up into sixth place early on. There he is on the 79 bike trying to find a way through on Celestin of Vietti, his closest championship rival at the moment, so he can see exactly where Vietti is directly ahead of him. Looking back now from race leader Joe Roberts, Jake Dixon there in second place. Canet slots himself into third position.
Looking further down then, there's been a disappointing first lap for Sam Lowes, unfortunately. He's now down to 11th position, started in 6th, so another poor opening lap for the Briton. His teammate, Tony Arbolino, has made progress. He's just a few positions behind him. No early progress for Pedro Acosta so far. He's dropped one position, he's 13th.
So lap one completed here in Catalonia. Joe Roberts has an advantage of just over 3/10 of a second ahead of British rider Jake Dixon in second spot. Albert Arenas now attacking Chelsea Vietti on the brakes into the first corner. He's got that move done. That's nice by Arenas then. Really nice move. So Vietti down in fifth place.
So Chelsea Vietti getting beaten up a little bit in these early stages. He's now got his nearest championship rival, Iagura, right behind him. They're level, of course, going into this race on 108 points. And very, very shortly, despite nine places between them on the grid, they could soon be swapping places. Canet now on the move. He's perhaps noticing that Joe Roberts is setting a fast early pace, and he pushes his way past Jake Dixon.
Yeah, Joe Roberts looking really, really strong in the early part of this Moto2 battle here in Barcelona. There's no way through for Dixon to fire back up the inside of Canet down the hill into turn number five. There's Marcel Schrotter at the moment, engaging in a pretty intense early battle with number 37, Augusto Fernandez. That's for 7th and 8th place.
Alonso Lopez is just behind them in 9th position, so the bet is currently swinging his way in the battle between the Bosque Scuro teammates, but Sam Lowes is just behind him. As I mentioned, no real progress early on for Pedro Acosta, who's had pretty good pace through free practice but got qualifying all wrong. He's still down in 13th position. He's just been passed by Philip Salach.
Poor qualifying yesterday really hurt the podium hopes of Somkiat Chantra, the Thai rider. He started down in 19th place. He's got himself early on though into point scoring places. He's 15th at the moment, just behind Tony Arbolino, as Augusto Fernandez sweeps up the inside and Marcel Schrotter through turn number 12. There's a big gap left open there by the German. Fernandez just switched straight on through, and now he's up into seventh.
Joe Roberts really into his rhythm out in the front, isn't he? His lead is around the half-second mark at the moment as they cross the line now to complete lap two of Aaron Canet. 44.5 then for the race leader.